So let's have a look on combine machine. This is the combine machine which works as a harvester and a thresher. Okay, this is the winnowing machine. These pictures are given in the PDF which I have shared earlier. So this is the winnowing machine, but it is done by men or women also, like this, where they are hitting the crop plant on a hard surface. This will separate the grains from the stalk of the plant. All right. Now, this is winnowing, how it is done by farmers. Okay. This is where we have grains. The heavier particle, that is wheat grains, they are fall straight to the ground. And the husk or the dry outer covering, it is moving far away from the grains. So, this is how we get grains, pure grains. Okay, now we have done all the agricultural practices and we have grains in our hand. So the next topic and the last topic is storage of grains. All right, so storage of grains we have to discuss now. So the harvested crop grains have more moisture content. So before storing them, the grains are properly dried in the sun to reduce the moisture in them. On a large scale, or we can say commercial scale, however, mechanical dryers with hot air blowing are used because the quantity is more. So what happens? We cannot keep whole grains outside in the sun, so we use mechanical dryers, which are used by people to dry the grains. So why we need to remove the moisture? Because if we will not remove the moisture, all the bacteria, insects, pests will grow in them. So to prevent the attack by insects, pests, bacteria and fungi, we have to remove the moisture from the grains. All right. Now on a small scale, farmers store grains in jute bags or metallic bins. Where do they store their grains? In jute bags or in metallic bins. On a commercial scale, food grains are stored in gunny bags, in granaries, or we can say grain silos. I will explain later what are grain silos. Now, how are they stored in the granaries, or we can say godowns? So the gunny bags filled with dried food grains, they are stacked in a large granary about 60 to 70 centimeter away from the walls and on the wooden platforms above 10 to 15 centimeter above the ground. Otherwise, they will catch the moisture. I will show you the picture. These are the stacks of gunny bags. This is how the gunny bags are stored in godowns, and in between these stacks we have pathways. Why pathways are there? Because these pathways are helping to do inspection whether the stacks of grains are fine or not, they are healthy or not, some moisture is not there, or if we want to fumigate any chemical. Okay, and these are silos, big containers in which grains are stored. Now come back to these points. So after storing them in the godown, we have to keep pathways in between so that periodic inspection, spraying and fumigation can take place. Fumigation means spraying, all right, spraying of chemicals. Now, this treatment protects the food grains from pests and microorganisms. And the grain silos, which I have just shown in the picture, they are big and tall cylindrical structures for storing the grains in large quantity. Now, they store different stocks of food items at different levels. Now, we can use dried neem leaves also for storing food grains at home. So this is at the low scale, that some farmers keep the grains at home also, so there they can use dried neem leaves. Now beta, all the agricultural practices are finished here. Now the last topic of your first chapter is food from animals. So till here we discussed how we get food from plants and what are the different practices we need to follow. Now comes to the next topic, food from animals. So like plants, there are several animals that are domesticated at home or in farms. Okay, we get milk, meat, eggs, honey, fish from animals. We all know this. These products form part of our food, which are we are habitual of it. They are our daily needs. All right. Now, animals need good food, shelter, and care for proper growth and food production. So the science which deals with breeding means you are keeping with them, you are keeping animals with you, you are giving them food, you are taking care of them. So this type of science is called animal husbandry. All right. Now we will learn few new terms related to agriculture and animal husbandry. So agriculture I already discussed, the growth of plant by using simple agricultural practices, and animal husbandry is the science that deals with the breeding, feeding and caring of domestic animals. So terms related to rearing of different animals. Rearing means you are taking care of animals, you are giving food to them, but there is some purpose behind it. You are taking some food item back from these animals. So the first one is apiculture. This is the term which is used for rearing of honeybees for honey. All right, you all know there is honey in the market. So from where it comes? So by this process, from apiary, these honey food items comes to us. All right, now comes to sericulture. What is sericulture? Rearing of silkworms for silk. So the process by which you are getting silk is called sericulture. Now come to the third one, that is pisciculture. So pisciculture means rearing of fishes. Okay, this is called pisciculture. Now terms related to agriculture of different crops. So first of all, we studied about agriculture. Now now we all know that the process of growing crops on a large scale is known as agriculture. But there are few terms, there are few things which you should know, which are not given in the book, but that is to enhance your knowledge. So the first one is horticulture. This term deals with the production and management of fruits and flowers. So this is the branch of agricultural science which deals with the study of growth of fruits and flowers. All right. Second one is olericulture. It deals with the production and management of vegetables. Third one is aquaculture. It is related to growth of aquatic plants and animals. Now the fourth one, agronomy. It is a branch of agricultural science that deals with the study of crops and the soils in which they grow. So beta, today by this topic, our first chapter, that is crop production and management, is finished. So now what you have to do, you have to share audio clips of your queries so that in next video, I will take all your queries. Thank you so much. I love you all. Take care of you.